Okay, today we're gonna be working on changing directions. The first exercise that we're gonna do, we're gonna divide the court on four squares. So the service line is gonna be helping us to divide the court. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the idea is on both sides of the court that the ball doesn't bounce on the same square two times in a row. So the idea, for example, if the ball bounces on square number 2, the next shot that you hit has to be on square 1, 3, or 4, and so far, so on. Okay, if you place to the same square, you lose a point. Okay, whoever wins a point will start the next point on their hand, first ball cross court. Okay, let's do it.
The coach will give the player some information to follow, and then the player must react and take his own decision. This type of practice introduces a wide range of information and skills. Players will learn in new situations and challenges. They also will acquire a feel for what works and what doesn't. Players will become more creative, but also disciplined during match play.
A variation or a progression of this exercise is whenever you hit the ball outside of the singles lines, I want you to go cross court. All right? Either it could be at sharp angle or deep on the court. Anytime you are inside the baseline and inside the singles lines, then it's the opportunity to change to down the line. All right? That is very important. The second thing is, anytime you're inside the court and the ball that you hit is below the level of the net, I want you to go with sharp angles. So those are the things that I want you to progress on when you're making this exercise. Good? Okay, let's do it.
In this type of practices, the player processes chunks of information in a random way. What is important to know is that in tennis, the player cannot play crazy shots. They have to follow a concrete, high percentage shot selection.
This exercise also helps to improve the court awareness, to read what ball you're receiving and what you can do with the ball that you're getting. So it's a very good exercise for intermediate and advanced players. Okay, the next drill that we're gonna do is gonna help us with the patterns. Tomás is gonna start serving out wide, and you, for the first ball that you hit, you're gonna hit to the open court. We're gonna do it first as a drill, and then we're gonna play points with that. All right, let's do it. The progression for this exercise is anytime that the ball bounces inside the service box, you're gonna have 2 feet inside the court, so you can take time away from the opponent. If the ball is short, but not short enough for you to put the 2 feet inside, that's okay. But at least 1 foot needs to be inside. So again, your body goes forward with the shot. Okay? Let's check it out.
Modest degree of instruction of how to start the point or how to finish the point, combined with higher random practices, increases the learning of tasks which are similar rather than different.
Wait, and then forward. Good. But keep going forward with the shot. On that shot, for example, hit the ball and go behind the shot.
In other words, the player will learn on his own that they are effective, basic patterns of play.
A progression of this drill is to play points. The server is going to serve to the deuce or to the outside with the purpose of taking the opponent outside of the singles or even double side, and to place the second shot that they hit to the open court. If they can hit that second shot with the forehand and they end up winning the point, they will get 2 points. That will be the reward of moving aggressive and trying to hit their weapon. Okay, make sure you make adjustment steps because you serve very well right there, but you stood where you end up serving. You have to adjust your feet in order to change directions to the ball. Making this exercise right when the server is serving out wide, it's important to adjust the feet after they finish the serving, because since we're going to be changing directions of the ball, which is the toughest thing in tennis to do, we need to have the right footwork to do it.
Very important to keep in mind the skill the player is trying to acquire.
With the next drill, we're going to be working on the patterns of the returner, especially for the second serve. if we combine men's and women's tennis, usually 50% of the time, these points are start with the second serve, are either won by the server or the opponent that is returning. So I'm gonna have the returning take the first strike and to be aggressive with that return. If you're receiving the second serve outside the singles line, your ball is gonna go cross court and you're gonna be aggressive with the return. If the ball is served to a T line, you're gonna go more to a down the line spot. Okay? So let's do that.
These variable practices are essential to the training sessions because they include frequent changes of tasks. The player is always alert, assimilating new information. This requires a higher mental effort. We use this training during the pre-competition phase.